Hello guys, welcome back to the St. Thomas School. Introduction to e-commerce, chapter number 4, part 1. About e-commerce. But in this video, we'll discuss about the half of the part of the chapter number 4. Means we'll understand what is e-commerce, what are the application of e-commerce. So let's get started. First, we will understand what is e-commerce. So, e-commerce means buying and selling of products, services, and information using electronic media like internet. What are the applications of e-commerce? So, e-commerce has huge applications, but here we are going to cover only the applications which are given in our textbook. Let's see what are the applications. The first, internet bookshop. Second, electronic newspapers. Third, online auction. Fourth, marketing and selling. Fifth, online billing. Sixth, information services. Seventh, support services. Eighth, net banking. One by one. Internet bookshop. Nowadays, customers prefer to purchase books on internet rather than going to the physical shop. Books can be easily shipped to the customer's place. A good online bookshop must display all the books category-wise. Category-wise means, suppose if you want to purchase the book for the maths, so there will be list of maths. If you want to purchase the book for the science, you can purchase the science. That's why a good online bookshop must display all the books category-wise, picture of the cover of page, description of the books, including the number of pages, price of the books, discounts, and the customer's review. This helps to purchase the book easily to the customer. Some popular online bookshops websites are as given: Amazon, Buy Books India, Books of India. Or if you don't know the name of website which is offering to sell the books, just write down the name of book in the Google and you can search it. You can also search by the publisher also, and you will get the particular publishing site, and from there you can also order. So we have a various option for purchasing the book online. Electronic newspaper. This is very popular because nowadays everyone has a mobile everywhere, so it's easy to get the news within a second what are happening in the world. Let's see what is inside. An electronic newspaper is also known as e-newspaper that exists on internet in digital form. It can give us up-to-date news on the issues that are happening worldwide. With advent of digital technology, the browsers can be set to select news as per the interest of reader. Advantages of the online newspapers are as given below. Extremely fast news. Why the fast news? Because within a fraction of a second, what are happening in the world, we are getting through the notification and we can see it. That's why it is very fast. Completely free. It's not chargeable. Once you have net connectivity, so you are not going to pay extra charge for seeing this news. Just we need to activate it as per your the choices, and you can get it free. That's why it's completely free. No personal information required. You might have observed when we log into the any other website and you try to access the data of that website, so you have to give your details like your ID, password of email ID. You have to give your name, age, but here there is no need to give your details to access the news. You can get it easily without giving any information about yourself. Interactive news. Interactive news means the news which you like to see, that can be possible to activate it. You can select as per your the choices to see the news. Suppose if you like to watch only from the particular reason, so you can get from there. If you want to watch from the sports, so you can see from the sports. If you want to watch from like movies and something. So you can select as per your choices. The last, that is environmental friendly. Why? Because you know that the news are published on the paper, and papers are made by the various plants. So here we are not going to cut the plants and something else, because this news are published on internet, and internet's storing this news in the digital form. That's why we are not going to use pages. We are going to save the pages. Online auction. This is also very popular. An auction is the process of buying and selling the products or services by offering the customers to bid the price and selling the products to the highest bidder. Means in this process, what we do? We offer to the customer to finalize the price of the product which you want to sell, and when you get the highest price, then you sell to that particular customer. To sell an item through an online auction site, we need to first register with the site. This is required to track the items you sell or bid on, determine the winning bids, and build a database of seller and bidder feedback. Member generally puts a digital picture of the items along with brief description about items. Means a person who wants to sell the products or services online, they have to mention digital picture of the items along with brief description about items. Means the name of the items, the quality of the items, etc. We have to mention so that our customers, those who want to purchase, can know about your products. Some sites are eBay, Online Auction, MyBids, YouBids. Marketing and selling. Many companies nowadays conduct their business of marketing and selling of goods and services by their own websites. They have already developed their own website, and through that website they are conducting their businesses. They provide their products catalog over internet for better marketing, and the catalog displays different categories of products with images. Even they are providing the videos, in some cases brief description and feature of the products, so that user can know about your products and can explore it and can like to purchase. The customer can view the catalog and select the products of their choice by adding them to the shopping cart. As you have seen, or when you have gone through offline purchasing, so you got trolley. In the trolley, that is cart, that is called the cart. In the cart, shopping cart, we put various items, and at the last we go to the billing counter for billing. Similarly, there is a digital shopping cart. There you can include the other products and finalize, and finally you can finalize for adding this bill. So customers can view the catalog and select the products of their choice by adding them to the shopping cart. When they finished, means when you have decided, now this is my products I want to purchase, and you have added to the shopping cart, then you need to finish it. The final billing is done for all the products in the shopping carts purchased by the customers. If you want add or remove or modify in the shopping cart, you can do this just by a single click. Yeah, once you have added the product to the shopping cart, if you want to modify, if you want to make it changes, you want to delete it from there, you can. Like that, when we purchase offline, so the product which you have added to the cart, if you want to remove it out, so you go and keep it from where you have tech. Similarly, you can remove it, you can modify it. It is also easy return. It's easy to return after purchasing. Today you can purchase almost all type products from the internet shop. We can make payment by various options like COD, cash on delivery, Paytm, phone pay, debit card, credit card, internet banking and e-wallets. These are the various options. In India, the COD, cash on delivery, is very famous. So through that you can make a payment. Some popular sites are Flipkart, Amazon, Myntra, and some other sites are also there. Online billing. Nowadays, the various bills can be paid online, like bijli bill, mobile phone bill, water bill, some other kind of the bills can be paid easily by net banking or by various e-wallets. So let's see. Nowadays, almost all companies offering to pay online bill using credit card, debit card, e-wallets, internet banking. Online billing is a way of making transaction or paying for goods and services through an electronic medium without the use of checks or cashes. It's also called electronic payment system or online payment system. The electronic payment system has grown increasingly over the last decades due to the growing speed of internet-based banking and shopping. As the world advances more with the technology and development, we can see the rise of electronic payment system and payment processing devices. As these increase, improve and provide ever more secure online payment transactions, the percentage of check and cash transactions will decrease. Information services. Information system is used by many organizations like colleges, schools and various educational institutions to publish latest information like result, online enrollment form, online exam, examination schedule, admission schedule, sitting arrangement and important notice. Banks are also using these services for their productivity. Information service is an integrated set of components used for gathering, processing, storing, and communicating multiple types of information for improved societal and organizational efficiency. Information system components cover academic and professional disciplines as spanning the fields of business and computer science. Typical information system includes data about people, software, hardware, and procedures. Collected digital data is used for study and analysis. Support services. Support services have become increasingly important due to use technological changes that have taken place in the last decade. Today, even the simplest products utilize sophisticated electronic, which requires specialized knowledge and technical ability for maintenance and support when any problem arises. You have faced many problems when you purchase your mobile phone. Your mobile phone is not working. If there is a defect in the mobile phone, then what you do? You just make a call to the customer here and you say, there is a defect in my phone, so I want to return, I want to get the solution of that. So you get knowledge from there, you get the solution from there, and then you solve the problem of your mobile phone. So that is the support services. After selling the products, companies are providing online support to the customers. For example, online complaint. Software companies are also providing online support to the customers for any problems while installation and using the software. For example, when you purchase online washing machine, refrigerator, or water filter. So companies are, or televisions, companies are providing the online services. They are sending the engineer to your home, and that engineers are going to set your the products and install the other products to your the home. Net banking. The online banking, also known as internet banking or web banking, it is an electronic payment system that enables customer of bank or other financial institutions to conduct a range of financial transactions through the financial institution's website. The online banking system will typically connect to or be a part of the core banking system operated by a bank, and is in contrast to branch banking, which was traditional way customers access banking services. What are the features of net banking? The customers using this facility can conduct transactional and non-transactional tasks, including the customers can view account statements, the customers can check the history of the transactions for a given period of by the concerned bank, bank statements, various types of forms, applications can be downloaded, the customers can transfer funds, pay any kind of bill, recharge mobile, DTH connections, etc. The customers can buy and sell on e-commerce platforms. The customers can invest and conduct trade. The customers can book transport, travel package, and medical package. How to get the net banking? To get the net banking, we have to visit to the bank, and we have to apply to get the net banking. Then the customer is provided the ID and the password from his or her bank when he or she applies to get the bank facilities. Nowadays almost all banks are offering these facilities, and once you get the ID and the password, then you can go for using the net banking. While getting the ID and the password, it is asked to you which kind of the services you want to get in the net banking, means that is called the rights. So you have to take the rights from the bank. So there will be option for checking the rights. So you can check the rights option while filling the form for getting the net banking facilities. Example of the banks are, which are providing the online services, online SBI, IOB, that is India of IOB.in, PNB India.in, Bank of Baroda.com. These are the few examples, but I think nowadays almost all banks are offering facilities. You can visit to the website of them and you can get the benefit of. Thank you for watching this video. We will see next video for the part 2. Thank you. Bye bye. See you.